taking photos of a couple of fish. I'm not really active with my tattoo with the other one. Can you send me some photos of the fish?
Well, good evening to you on this fine April night. On behalf of the GMC Board of Trustees and our President and Lieutenant General William B. Caldwell IV, I want to welcome you to the 2021 Grand Tattoo. My name is Greg Corwin, and I will be your narrator for this evening's event. We are absolutely honored that you would join us on these historic grounds as we celebrate the military heritage of our institution, and also those who contributed to our strong legacy and the students that we continue to serve today. Now, as we begin, I would like to welcome students from our very own Preparatory School Performing Arts Program. We're going to share their musical talents with you under the direction of Mark Weaver and Jenny Morris. And our first performers are our GMC elementary students from grades 3 through 5. They will be singing God Bless America and This Land Is Your Land. You would please welcome them to the stage. The GMC Prep High School Girls Trio will be singing their song, I will. Literary team winning the overall region championship for the team. would now ask if you would please direct your attention directly across the field as the John Moore McIntosh pipes and drums marches towards us.
Thank you.
The flag-folding ceremony represents the same principles on which our country was originally founded. The portion of the flag denoting honor is the canton of blue containing the stars representing the states our veterans served in uniform. The canton of blue dresses from left to right and is inverted when draped as a pall on a casket on a veteran who has served our country in uniform. Please stand. As we retire the colors, we will fire a ceremonial round from GMC's PAC-75 World War II howitzer. For our guests in uniform and our veterans as desired, please render the hand salute. For our guests in civilian clothes, please place your right hand over your heart. Ladies and gentlemen, may lower your saluted hands from your heart. Please take your seats. The first fold stands for life. The second fold represents eternal life. The third fold honors and remembers the veteran departing our ranks and who gave a portion of his or her life for the defense of our country. The fourth fold represents our weaker nature. As American citizens trusting in God, it is Him we turn to in times of peace as well as in times of war for His divine guidance. The fifth fold is tribute to our country. In the words of Stephen Decatur, our country in dealing with other countries, may she always be right, but it is still our country, right or wrong. The sixth fold is for where our hearts lie. It is with our heart that we pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. The seventh fold is a tribute to our armed forces, for it is through the armed forces that we protect our country and our flag against all enemies, foreign and domestic. The eighth fold is a tribute to the one who entered into the valley of the shadow of death, that we might see the light of day, and to honor our mother, for whom it flies on Mother's Day. The ninth fold is a tribute to womanhood. It has been through their faith, love, loyalty, and devotion that has molded the character of the men and women who have made this country great. The tenth fold is a tribute to Father, who has also given his sons and daughters for the defense of our country since he or she was first born. The 11th fold represents the lower portion of the seal of King David and King Solomon and glorifies the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. The 12th fold represents an emblem of eternity and glorifies God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The 13th fold and last fold, when the flag is completely folded, the stars are uppermost, reminding us of our national motto, In God We Trust. The flag is now completely folded and tucked, and it takes on the appearance of a tri-cornered hat, very emblematic of the hats worn by colonial soldiers during the War for Independence. In the folding, the red and white stripes are finally wrapped into the blue as the light of day retreats into the darkness of night. If you would please stand and join us for the playing of taps. For our guests in uniform and our veterans as desired, please render the hand salute. For our guests in civilian clothes, please place your right hand over your heart. I salute you and goodbye. Well, this year, you will say farewell to three individuals who contributed greatly to Georgia Military College and the Georgia Military College Foundation with their time, talent, and treasure. Our first honoree tonight is Dr. John Ferguson, textbook class of 1961, junior college class of 1963, distinguished alumnus and servant leader. Dr. John Ferguson loved GMC with all his heart. He was an incredible supporter of the GMC mission, but especially for our students. Over the years, Dr. and Mrs. Ferguson contributed in many ways to GMC, not only in service, but financially as well. His involvement in daily participation in doing everything possible to ensure that GMC was able to support every student was absolutely commendable. He was honored with the GMC Distinguished Alumnus Award in 2007 with appreciation of his service to our country and to his alma mater for re-engaging so many alumni with the school. Dr. Ferguson's service with GMC included Alumni Association President on two different occasions, a trustee and member of the GMC Foundation, the first vice chairman of the GMC Foundation, chairman of the GMC Foundation Development Committee, also chairman of the GMC Annual Giving Campaign. Dr. Ferguson's demonstration of excellence and character, exemplary leadership served as an inspiration to others and still does today. He was a true gentleman, and a caring, community supporter, and servant leader. Because of his gracious time and service to GMC, Dr. Ferguson's legacy will never be forgotten. We're honored to have Mrs. Jenny Ferguson and her family here tonight as our guests. We thank you for gracing us with your presence as we picture you together. So ladies and gentlemen, if you would please grab your glass, please rise and join me in a toast to Dr. John Ferguson. Please be seated. Mr. Winston H. Sibley, honorary alumnus and steadfast supporter. Winston Sibley played a huge role at Georgia Military College and prep school, where he was an honorary alumnus. The Sibley family built the Sibley Home Library right over here at GMC, and Win served as a trustee on the GMC Foundation Board for over 20 years. And he continued to support GMC through the legacy of his children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren. Mr. Sibley worked tirelessly to ensure the success of the school. And his service was acknowledged in 1996 when he was given that title of honorary alumnus. Mr. Sibley ensured the library remained an integral part of the GMC educational experience and invested his own time, talent, and treasure to make even aesthetic improvements when necessary, such as restoring the beautiful piano in the Sibley Room. Mr. Sibley served GMC in many ways. He was a trustee and member of the GMC Foundation, chairman of the GMC Foundation Rules and Nominations Committee, and also a member of the GMC Foundation Finance Committee. I think all knew him would agree. He was intelligent, he was humble, he was generous, and was a gentleman to all who were blessed to know him. We are honored to have Mrs. Dot Sibley, family, and close friends here tonight to pay tribute to him as our guests. Thank you for gracing us with your presence, my friends. So if you would please rise again with your glasses. And I offer up a toast to Mr. Winston Sibley. You may be seated. Last honoree this evening is Dr. James L. Strong, devoted friend and valued advisor. Dr. Strong was a firm believer that higher education is a key to lifelong success. So much so, in fact, that he spent his career in philanthropic endeavors for many noteworthy colleges and universities. He himself saw great value in the way that GMC affects the lives of young people in positive ways, and even in his retirement, chose to volunteer as campaign consultant for GMC's Health and Wellness Capital Campaign. His belief at GMC's important work for our country's future. Led him to serve as a trustee of the GMC Foundation for many years. And he and Margaret, his lovely wife of 59 years, established a planned gift. The entire school has greatly benefited from his immense knowledge on philanthropy and his commitment to this institution. Dr. Strom is extraordinarily generous with his time, treasure, and many talents. We are honored tonight to have Dr. Strom's son, Mr. Mark Strom, and his wife, Julie, here tonight as our guests. And his devoted wife, Mrs. Margaret Strom, is watching on the live stream this evening from her home with other family members. We are so glad that you can be part of this through technology. We appreciate all of you being here as we pay tribute to your husband, father, and grandfather. So if you would please stand with your glasses one more time. And I offer a toast to Dr. James Strom. To these three men, we say, I salute you, and goodbye. Make it easy. I'm going to ask if you would please join me in two final toasts. I know you've been wanting to drink from your glass, you haven't thought of you. The responses for these are on the toast card that you received as you came in. So our first toast, ladies and gentlemen, I propose President of the United States and to the United States of America. God bless you. We will now have the honor of the Georgia Military College Cadet Glee Clubs under the direction of Professor Moodyu singing our alma mater. Now we are especially proud of our Glee Club as the members are made up of the men and women of the Cadet Corps. This year marks the very first female cadet glee club in the history of Georgia Military College. We'll let you know that the first stanza and chorus are printed for you on your toast card. And we ask that as they begin, you would please stand and join the glee club in singing as we honor this institution and the United States of America. Stand as we begin to sing.
Thank you.
now my privilege to introduce the president of Georgia Military College, Lieutenant General William B. Caldwell IV, Sheriff Hero Works.
First of all, I'm probably kicked out, but everybody got involved tonight. Everybody's excited to be out, to be a part of something that we have not been able to do for over a year. So this is a big event for Georgia Military College tonight. And to all of you here, we want to say thank you for joining us on this very special evening. On behalf of my boss, the chair of the board of trustees, Chairman George Trumpet, and the other members of the board of trustees that are here, and two of our former presidents are with us tonight. We've got Dean Acker over here, representing Major General Bill Acker. Obviously, Bill is deceased and passed, but we're thrilled that Dean can be joining us from Texas. And then Major General Peter Boyle and his wife, Kathy. Thank you very much, both of you. All of us want to welcome you tonight. As you listened to the GMC alma mater somewhere at Glee Club, you heard the words, loyal all our being, year by year, the marching onward. And that's what your GMC team and your GMC family have done this past year. In a time of great uncertainty, our team persevered. When the world paused, we persisted. The hard work and dedication of each and every GMC team member, faculty and staff, made it possible for us to do what we do best, providing hope and opportunity to students. Colonel Pam Graham and her team reopened NC instruction last June, and they never looked back, providing an entire year of NC education, never shutting down one class or ever closing the school. In our junior college, Joe Yearwood and our global online college had already been growing, but when the switch had been made to remote learning, it was very seamless, and all of our students were able to very quickly, rapidly continue with their education. At our junior college campuses, with regional directors like Brigadier General Donahue here, Colonel Nelson Kraft, we were able to resume NC instruction last August for our students. Many of them, that's so critical for them to be in sync with instructors in the classrooms. And that's exactly what we provided for this past year. These actions enabled us to be in sync all year, but yet there was still another challenge. Many of our students were suffering financially and needed help. And that's where most of everyone here stepped in, represented by our GMC Foundation and Mr. Dudley Rowe here, and assured us they would have the financial support they needed so that any student at Georgia Military College who wanted to continue their education would be able to do so. And tonight we're thrilled to be able to share with you that you, everyone here tonight, made a difference in the lives of countless students, best represented by the fact that this school year we're currently on glide path to have the largest number of associate degrees ever awarded in the history of Georgia Military College. Thank you. You all provided that hope and opportunity at a time when it was needed most, and your generosity speaks volumes for what the results were. Tonight, we remember three men. They were torchbearers for all of us. Dr. John Hungerson, Winston Sibley, and Dr. James all lived their lives in service to others, and we at GMC benefit immensely from their generosity and their love for this institution. Again, I want to thank everybody for joining all of us tonight. This is a very special occasion for us. We're excited to be back out and about. So with that, I'm going to turn it back over to Craig Corwin and let him close us out. Thank you.
Challenges none of us could plan for. And the key to the success of Georgia Military College during this crisis has been your unwavering commitment to provide the safest environment for our students to continue to develop their intellect and elevate their character. And as a reflection of our attitude, sir, I would like to welcome Colonel Tom Torrance, President of the Georgia Military College Alumni Association, to make a special presentation.
Thank you, Craig. It's an honor to be here tonight and to participate in this
restoration of Jenkins Hall and the addition of the prep school
annex, the establishment of the Bachelor of Applied Science degree, established partnerships with the U.S. Navy Academy and the Air Force Academy as preparatory schools, the opening of campuses in Fayetteville, Dublin, Eastman, Zebulon, construction of the Center for Ethics and Servant Leadership, the addition of men's and women's soccer and rifle to the junior college athletic program, an increase in value of the GNC Foundation by approximately $24 million, and the recognition nationally as a predominantly black institution at the junior college level. While you may not have attended GNC yourself, there is no doubt your deep connection to GNC and the values of duty, honor, country, and character of all that you hold so dear. You are a part of the George Military College legacy, and tonight we want to make it official by bestowing on you the title of honorary alumnus. This forever makes you an alumnus of George Military College with all the rights and privileges given to all of our alumni. So if you please come up here and join me and Mr. George Hogan and Mr. Bentley Rowe, if you don't know that,
that make this so special. I mean, not that you forget me. You are what makes this special. So we invite you to join us as we have our reception. Food is inside the atrium. We are seating inside and outside. So thank you again for all you do to carry on the legacy of Georgia Military College. Please enjoy the feast. Thank you.
I was a freshman when you were here. It's been a long time.
Look, I took a bit. Okay, what kind of work?
Hey, how you doing?
You got a sense of humor, right?
Yes. Oh, my God.